Assalamu alaikum. Welcome students. Today we will discuss about iteration statements. In last class we discussed about control statements. In that two types of statements we are using in C++. One is a selection statement, another one is iteration statement. Now today we will see about iteration statements. Iteration statements. As we know, iteration means loop. We also call this as loop statements. When there are a set of instructions are there, we need to execute repeatedly. At that time, we are using these iteration statements. Clear? A set of instructions or a single instruction is there that should be executed repeatedly for a fixed number of times or until the condition is true. At that time, we are using this iteration statement. In that, three types of statements are there. One is while loop statements, do while loop. Third one is for loop. These are the loop means nothing but executing repeatedly. We are executing a single statement or a set of statement more than one time. At that time we call that as a loop. Here now we will see one by one while loop, do while and for loop. We see while loop. In while loop, a single statement or a set of statements are there that should be executed repeatedly until the condition is satisfied. Now we will see the syntax of while loop is while. We are writing the while loop using the keyword while condition. Within the block there are statements are there. Yeah. This is the while loop syntax. Here we are providing condition. If this condition is true, it will execute. Otherwise, it will not execute. Until the condition is true, repeatedly it is executing. For example, we will see. C is equal to y. A is less than or equal to 5. C out A, displaying the value of A here. Now here we are providing the condition, the variable A value until it is less than or equal to 5, this will be executed. Within this, we are incrementing the value of A. A++ means it is an increment operator. It increments the value of A at a time, one value at a time. We already discussed about this. Now, initially, I am giving value of A is equal to 2. I am giving value of A. Now, we will see how it will work. See, first it will check the value. 2 is less than or equal to 5, yes, condition is true, then it will execute. But it display the value of value here, output I will write. Value is 2. I will write here. Out 2 is the output. Then it will increment value of A++. A becomes 3. 3 is less than or equal to 5. Again it will go while, check the condition. 3 is less than or equal to 5. Yes, it is true. It display the output 3, then it will increment the value A become now 4. Again it will check the condition. 4 is less than or equal to 5, yes it is true. It will execute this, it becomes 4. Now increment the value, it becomes 5. 5 is less than or equal to 5, yes true. It will display 5. Again it will increment 5, it becomes 6. 6 is less than or equal to 5, no it is false. Then it will come out of the loop. Here this is about the while loop. Until the condition is true, it keep on executing this block of the instructions. This is about while loop. Now we will see do while also work as same as while loop, only until the condition is true it will execute. If the condition is false, then it will come out of the loop. But main thing is here, one important thing is there, do while loop. Here while loop we call it as a pre-tested loop. while loop we call it as a pre-tested loop. Do while we call it as a post-tested loop. In while loop, first it will check the condition, then it will execute. Here in do while, it will execute the code, the syntax. If you write the syntax, do, here statements are there, then while loop, then condition is there, while, here condition. This is the syntax of that. First, one time it will execute this code, then it will check the condition. If it is true, then it will go back here, execute this, until the condition is true. But in while loop, what happens? It will first check the condition, then it will execute. So, do while is the post-tested loop, while is the pre-tested loop. Before executing, it will test the condition. Here, after executing, it will check the condition. We'll see one example for do while, then you will understand. Do cout a plus plus while a is less than 3. This is the code. Initially, I am giving value of a is equal to 3 only. I am giving here. A is equal to 3. First, how it will execute? First, it will check. First, it will execute the code. The output, first, it will execute a. A, it will display 3. Then, after, it will execute the value of 3. Now, 3 becomes 4. Now, it will check the condition here. 4 is less than 3. No, it is false. It will come out of the loop. Clear. If it is true, for example, here I am giving a is less than 8, but then what happened? It will check the value 3 incremented 4 is less than 8. Yes, it is true. Again, it will execute this 3, it will display 4, then increment the value 4, then it becomes 5. 5 is less than 8. Yes, it is true. It will display 5, like that 6, 7, 8. Until 8, it will display. After displaying 8, it will check here, 8 is less than 8, no, it is false, it come out of the loop. Clear? If condition is true or if condition false also, it will execute this code once. That is in do while. Clear about this? Now we will go for next loop, that is for loop. For loop. For loop we also call it as fixed loop. Fixed loop. Fixed loop means when we know, in beginning only we know how many times we need to execute the particular code, particular instructions, at that time we are using this for loop. That's why it is a fixed loop. So we already know, in beginning only we know how many times we should execute that at that time. For example, the syntax of for loop is syntax for, here some variable we are giving, variable initializing, variable initialize, comma, condition, comma, increment or decrement. Here statement, body of the for loop. Here, see, in for loop what happened? The initialization of the variable and the condition and the increment or decrement, all are given in a single line. In single line we are given. In while loop you can see we are giving only condition in while. In do while also the increment or initialization we are not providing here in that while or do while. We need to write separate instruction for that, separate code for that. But in for loop, all initialization, condition and increment or decrement we are added in the same line only, in single line. So this is a fixed loop. Let's we will see one example how the for loop will be work. For example, I want to display 10 numbers. 10 numbers I want to display. At that time, how to we write for. Initially I am giving I is equal to 0. From 0 to 10 I need to initialize here. Now I am giving the condition. How many number? The condition is I is less than or equal to 10. Instead of 10 we will take 5. 5. I want to display 0 to 5 numbers at that time. I is less than or equal to 5. Now I plus plus. Here I plus plus means increment. See, two things are there you should remember. One is plus I plus plus. One another one is plus plus I. These two are different. Here what happen? First it will display execute, then it will increment the value. Here first it will increment, then it will execute the one, then it will execute. While writing the program I will explain once again that. Now we will see, go for here. Here now I want to display C out I. This much only I want to display. How it will work? I plus plus, you are closing here. See, for loop, how it will, while executing first, we are initializing the value I is equal to 0. I is less than or equal to 5. This is the condition. This is the increment. We are incrementing here. Now we will see how it is. First, what happened? It will check I is equal to 0 condition. 0 is less than or equal to 5. Yeah, yes, it is true. The output it will display 0. I plus plus, first it will execute, then it will increment. Now it will increment, I value become 1. 1 is less than or equal to 5, yes, it will execute here, it will display 1. Then I value will be increment by 1. It become 2 is less than 5, it display 2. Like 3 is less than or 5, it display 3. 4 is less than or equal to 5, yes, 4. Next. 5 is less than or equal to 5, yes, 5. 6 is less than or equal to 5, it is false. Now it is come out of the loop. Clear? This is how for loop will be working. Same thing, initialization, condition and increment or decrement, we are providing in a single code. And we are, when until this condition is true, it will execute the particular of the code. Once this condition is false, it come out of the loop. Clear? This is about the for loop. So we discussed today about iteration statements. Iteration statements. What is iteration? Iteration statement means when we want to execute the particular code, a set of codes repeatedly for a fixed number of times or until the condition is satisfied, we are using the iteration statement. Iteration statement. In that we discuss while loop, do while loop, next for loop. These three loop statements are there. While loop we also call it as pre-tested. First it will check the condition, then it will execute. Do while loop we also call it as post-tested loop. First it will execute, then it will check the condition. For loop we also call this as a fixed loop. In beginning only we know how many times we need to execute the code. At that time we are using this for loop. And in for loop, initialization, condition and increment or decrement we are providing in a single code in for loop. Clear? If you have any doubt in this iteration statement or complete control statement, you can ask me. In next class we will see another topic. Thank you.